Here we are on the weekend at S&S Turbines. It's not a windy day, so we can play outside. You see, I'm wearing the other company's hat. You want Rolls-Royce? You talk to Maddox Turbines. You want GE? S&S. Number one in both fields. Okay, one question I get all the time is, how does a jet engine make electrical power? Well, we have, in our junkyard, an old, tired, rusted and destroyed machine that does just that. This is what you hook up behind an LM1500. It's called a power turbine, and I'm going to see if I can look inside it. It's been cut up because we didn't need this. We needed the engine in front of it. You can see it's a little damaged. Let's see what's inside. I'm going to climb up here somehow. Okay. You've got your, looks like the back of a jet, doesn't it? It's just bigger. This is the shaft, the output shaft that's been cut. You can see the drive spline right there. This has been cut with a torch to remove this whole unit. This is a seal for the, what is it for? Oh, this keeps the hot exhaust gases away from the shaft that's turning whatever it's turning. There's the shaft. There's the back end of the power turbine. And it is turned by the gases coming out of the turbine engine or jet engine. These are the struts. Those struts support the main bearing, which is right down in there. And this big ugly thing is a power turbine. Now you can see that a power turbine looks a lot like the back end of a jet engine because it's built exactly the same way, just larger, for slightly lower temperature and lower velocity. And instead of the shaft going to the front, which the exhaust gases come this way into it, so instead of the turbine shaft going forward to drive a compressor, the shaft goes out the back, and it drives the mechanical load, whatever that might be. Electrical generator, gas compressor, a ship's propeller. But if you look at this thing, it looks very similar to the hot end or the back end of the engine it's attached to. Right down there, there's the flange with those little holes. That matches up exactly with the back flange of the LM1500. This is how a jet exhaust is turned into a lot of horsepower turning a rotating shaft.